What's up, everybody? The Destroyer here. Welcome back to the Lord of the Skyrim's Berethor's Quest, the Skyrim playthrough to rule them all. This is part 24, and we continue on through the Clockwork questline, which, of course, is playing some horrific sound. So, I think we should probably move. I'm not sure if we go this way or this way, actually. Oh. Well, that answers that question, doesn't it? This way it is. I feel like we should run. Make it a little more frantic. Oh, God. Another cave in. Oh, Jesus. Okay. That probably is the way to go, so we'll go this way first. Oh. Ooh. Son of a bitch. They're caving in everywhere. Well, there's definitely no going back now, huh? Holy shit. But I will take this moment to explore this room. Oh, I gotta do this. What? Wait, what? Oh, okay. Alright, so I think we're out of the tunnels, actually. We lost the ghost chick, I think? Maybe? Find a way out of the lofty tunnels. Explore the valley. Okay, well, that was interesting. I will wait till it's daytime, though. Just to make it easier on everyone's eyes, I think. Would be the best course of action. And then we'll explore the grounds. So apparently this questline is 5 to 7 hours long. So that'll be a thing. We'll be here for a bit. I don't mind, personally. As long as it's interesting, which I hear it is. Huh. That's kind of cool, actually. As long as it doesn't stay there, like, permanently. Nice little title screen, though, I guess, for his mod. Or her mod. I don't know. I think it's a dude, though. Oh, it disappears. That's really cool. Alright. Oh, hello. So this must be Clockwork Castle, I'm guessing. I don't know what gives me that idea. There's a person over there we'll talk to in a moment. I'm a monster. I'm sorry. Poor bunnies. Anything over here? Anything at all? It's a nice place. Looks nice. Okay. I don't think there's anything out here, to be honest. So we'll go up to the gates. We'll say hello. Did I save? Maybe. Let me do it again. Yes, we did. I'll just save over. Alright. Hello, sir, or madam, or... Hello. Or whatever you are. Hello? I hope so. So it's apparently some sort of robot. Most interesting. Let's take a look at the grounds here. Well, we look marvelous in our paladin armor. I do love this armor, actually. It looks very cool. The helmet especially looks cool. I just wish I could use my own cape. I don't mind the cape it comes with, but it's a little short. It's not really, but I personally like really long capes. It's just a personal preference, though. I think this cape is just fine. It's actually a nice color and stuff, though. Nice violet, I guess? Purple-ish with a gold trim, something like that. Whatever the hell that color that is. Fits nicely with a white armor. Alright. How interesting. You got it. Dude, Jesus, you look terrifying. My lantern on. Okay. So apparently there's no lights on currently. So it'll be a bit dark without it, but he'll turn the lights on soon, he said. It's a very interesting, different design kind of thing than you'd be used to in Skyrim, huh? Kind of like a Victorian castle of sorts. Which is what he was going for, obviously. Alright. Just keep following Lahar up to Lanashtu, do you say the name was? Something like that. Covered. Don't mind if I do. Haha. Free gold. I like this mod already. Clockwork Castle grounds. Okay. I'm ready. Oh, Jesus. I'm doing just that.
Here we are. Our party 2 is just over there. Please introduce yourself to her. In the meantime, I shall delight the lamps that are not at yours.
How generous.
Please excuse me.
Well, at least the voice acting's pretty good. Granted, there hasn't been too much already, but the robotic voices are good. Hello?
Who are you, and what are you doing here?
Interesting voice box. It's like a record player thing. It's weird. I came through the mountain tunnels.
And the tunnel collapsed. Yes, I heard it. No one has used those tunnels in well over 100 years.
Ooh.
There is only one other way out of the castle and this valley. Beneath the keep is the travel machine. It can transport you to the major settlements of Skyrim. Ask Lahar to take you to it. He will need to let you out on the other side.
Can I ask you something?
Go to Lahar. Ask him to let you out through the travel machine.
Apparently not. Okay, can I talk to her again?
No.
No? Look at those dwarven tits. They had to go through the extra thing to put those on there. We really want to identify this as a female. Let's put some tits on it. Seems reasonable, I suppose. Alright. Let's go find Lushtar. Are the lights on? Let me see. Yeah. I mean, it's still nicer with my light on, though. So I'll keep my my lantern on, but... looks pretty cool. So this becomes a house mod, apparently. At some point. Staying? Lamashtu said you'd show me to this travel machine.
That is strange. The travel machine is not functional at this time. In fact, very few machines here are working right now, as the pressurized steam they rely on is not reaching the castle. Perhaps she forgot. Yeah, I can show you. The travel machine is this way, beneath the cube. Please, come this way.
Okay. Sure, why not? Their voices can be a little low, I'm noticing, compared to the music. Let me just see if I can fix that. Voice is up high all the way, music is not. I'll turn that down just a smidge. Alright. Just so I can hear them better. I'll turn it back up later, though, because I do like the music. Travel room. Sounds intriguing. Let's have a look. I know what it looks like already, but I'm sure many of you have no idea. I don't know how it works or anything, though, so...
Please, come this way.
Could be interesting. Brooms. Fur pelts, butter pelts. I'm not going to loot all this garbage. It definitely works on, like, steam clockwork kind of stuff, as you notice. I'll actually take that. Probably wondering, why would I take dwarven oil? Oh, wait, I don't need it anymore. Now that I think about it. I needed dwarven oil to make my crossbow, the dwarven crossbow, but I instead bought one from the chick. So. Ah, the travel machine.
Try entering the machine. You shall see that it is not working.
Okay. So you press a button. And it's supposed to, like, Stargate style, switch the dial, and then you teleport to whatever city it goes to. Which is pretty cool. So you have your own little teleporter from this house mod. Which is interesting, to say the least.
As you can see, the machine is cold to the lifeless.
Just like you.
I'm afraid you cannot leave.
Is there no other way out?
No. The cliffs surrounding the castle are too steep to traverse. And now that the last tunnel has fallen in, no avenues remain.
Oh dear.
To be honest, I have thought the route you took to reach here to be blocked on the other side for a very long time now. After all, we are subject to the occasional tremor here. From Red Mountain, I believe. In fact, one such tremor is to blame for the lifeless machines around the castle. It was particularly violent and breached the main steam pipeline.
Oh boy.
I attempted to repair the damage, but my brothers and sisters hampered my efforts and drove me out.
Brothers and sisters? I was just thinking that, actually.
Now you learn to run, deep beneath the castle. They have grown wild, and we are no longer welcome there.
Can I repair the damage?
Good. Doing so would restore steam power to the castle, yes. The pipeline ferries steam from deep beneath the ground, but it is easy to find. It can be followed back through the castle. And it is spewing steam. From what I saw, at least 10 sections of pipe have been breached. All must be replaced.
Ugh, God.
Fortunately, plenty of scavenged replacement pipes are lying about down there. They were intended for eventual use in the castle. Alternatively, if you know how to work with the metal, you may want to use one of the forges down there to cast your own.
I can do that.
Oh, yes.
May. They will attack me. Let's be honest. Will do. Ooh, that's nice. Let's see. Which parts of the castle can you show me to?
I can show you the master bedroom, kitchen, travel room. I can also explain the workings of the pneumatic tube terminals about. Please let me know if you would like me to show you somewhere.
Nah, we don't need to take him anywhere, but let's see what he has to ask. What are you, even?
I am a caretaker. I see to it that the castle is kept in good repair.
No, I mean, are you one of the Dwemer and Animunculi? I don't know how you say that.
I am a caretaker.
Animunculi?
Once the travel machine is again functional, I can use it to trade for necessities with merchants in Skyrim. I will be able to arrange trades for you at that time.
Neat. How do you go out in public? Aren't you treated with suspicion? You wear robes.
Yes, and observers believe that beneath the robes, I am wearing a suit of Dwemer armor.
I guess that makes sense. Tell me about the castle.
Clockwork Castle sits high in the Velody Mountains that border Skyrim and Morrowind. It is naturally well defended by virtue of its very remote and treacherous surrounds. It was built by the Clockwork family in the closing years of the Third Era, some 200 years ago.
Damn.
The Clockwork family were very successful traders, and the castle was intended to administer a new trading route between Skyrim and Morrowind. However, the devastation of the Red Year put an end to those plans by way of destroying the trade route and the people they wished to trade with. So I was told, at least. That was all before my march to that I came here.
Alright. Oh god, there's a lot to ask. We'll ask him later, eh? Let's get some going. I see something up there, though. I noticed out the corner of my eye there's a potion in there.
Yes.
Ooh. Careful. Alright, let's go get the, let's have a look around the castle, shall we? Let's go check out that master bedroom. And other things, I guess. It is a castle, after all. Soon to be our home, I guess. Let's check out the armory. I may actually switch to using this player home once we finish up. If it's cool. It seems like it's pretty cool already, so I think I'm already sold, but we'll have a look. Aw, this is definitely cool. Chest for heavy armor. Display cases. Chest for light armor. Cabinets for staves. Clothing. Ammunition. Lots of mannequins. Weapon mounts. Ah, yeah. Now we're talking. I actually like the layout as well, because you get to walk through like your suits of armor and weapons on the walls and stuff. That's kind of cool. Oh, sick. What are these? Are these weapon mounts? What are they? They're not interactable, so I don't... I thought they were like things you'd place a weapon on or something, but it didn't seem to be. Alright then. Mask head form. How do you use that? Let's just test it. Only mask can be placed here. Oh, it's a thing for masks only. Like the face masks. Dragon claw mount. Really? Well, I don't know what happens to your dragon claws after you finish with them, actually, so. Okay. This is for a wardrobe. So far, seems pretty cool. I like the armory. Alright, let's go see what the rest of the house has in store. Not bad so far. I do like the Riverside Lodge, though. I'll still use it, probably. Nah, I probably won't. If I switch, I'll probably completely switch. I see no reason to have two houses. Plus, what's this? I crash a lot when going to Riverside Lodge for some reason. Workroom is closed. The corrosive vapors. Thing can be purged. The exhaust fans are currently non-functional due to the breaches in the steam pipeline. Okay, so we can't go in here until we fix the steam pipeline. Fair enough. Which will be a task in itself, it sounds like. I guess we could guess this is the kitchen. That would make sense. There's the pantry. Or not the pantry, the freezer. That's kind of cool to use the natural cold in that room to act as a freezer. That's pretty neat. Freezer slash refrigerator, I guess. Very cool. Alright, so that's that part of the castle. Let's see what's this way. Master bedroom will be upstairs, undoubtedly. There's a dining room. There's another way upstairs. Let's check out the dining room. Very cool. Okay, that leads back around. Let's go upstairs. We'll take this way, I guess. We'll come back down the master staircase. Oh, jeez, it's more than two levels tall. I guess that's not surprising, but for some reason it was. Oh, well, there we go. Ah, marvelous. That's kind of cool. Alright, let's see. Living quarters. Alright. I wonder what these, oh, the LQ, living quarters. I was about to say, what do these letters stand for? And immediately figured it out. Right. So I think you can actually move, if you get married, like, you can get married in Skyrim, obviously, you can have kids. You can move your kids and your family into this house. So that's undoubtedly what this area is for. Oop, there's another door in there. Ooh. Fancy. Can we? I'm so immersed. You're now clean from bathing. Wait, maybe that should be the thumbnail. It's such a ridiculous thumbnail. Oh, come on. Let me have this. It's hard to get an angle, though. Because when you zoom out... I could zoom out maybe beforehand. This is gonna be the dumbest thumbnail. Ah, there we go. A paladin in full armor sitting in a bathtub. Fucking awesome. Alright, that's cool. It's got its own bathtub. At least it doesn't remove all my armor like that other one did in the Forgotten City. I appreciate the fact it does remove your armor for, like, immersive... Thank God they're not naked. For immersive reasons. But... it's annoying to have to equip the shit again. So, I'm alright with that. This is quite the, quite the furnace. Water? Jesus, this place is sprawling. It was the hall. Where does this go? How many people can you move in this fucking place? I know it's a castle, but Jesus. It's a pretty big place. I wonder if you can have, like, all of your followers move into this place. That'd be kinda cool. So, like, go home to this place. And, like, Boromir and Legolas and all them would, like, come here. I'm kinda neat.
Do you need something?
Nope. I'm good. That's the master bedroom. A mage's study. Ooh. Undoubtedly gonna be full of books and shit. Ooh. It's like a proper library staircase. Very cool. Hope you're having that. Even though really I'm just destroying the aesthetic of my own house. it's gotta happen. Oh, you can sort the books by letters. That's actually convenient. So if you know what book you're looking for, you can just look in the letter. The lighting flickering is definitely part of my lantern mod. If I turn it off, you don't see that. But it'll be a bit dark. Yeah. What is that a shadow of? Surely that's not the shadow of that. Maybe it is. To the glass garden. I'm intrigued. Well, garden's a little dead. Which is not surprising, I guess. I wonder if we can regrow it. Ah! Cool. So at least the castle grounds. I'll leave that going, I guess. Maybe it'll revitalize the garden or some shit. Who knows? Very cool. Okay, now where do I go? Is that an enchantment table? Yeah, cool. Actually, do I need to disenchant anything? It's incomplete and cannot be used. Oh, we gotta actually fix it. The fuck? Fair enough. I guess once we get our castle actually working in order again. It's not our castle yet as well, so I guess that's a reasonable thing as well. Okay, let's check out the master bedroom, and then we'll go continue the quest line. I do apologize, I'm doing a lot of exploring, but I've never seen the castle before, so I'm just as curious as some of you might be. A safe. I'm actually going to leave the gold there for aesthetic reasons. I say that, but I'm too greedy. Is it just me, or... I still see the shadow of the gold bag there. Oh, spooky! Oh, come on. I gotta resist the urge to take all this gold and stuff. Fuck. Fuck! I didn't want either of those rolls of paper. Oh, I'm ruined. The aesthetic is just being crushed by my loot whore ways. Let me fix this. I can fix this. I can make it better. That's not too bad. What's this? Oh, there's gold on it. Ludwig's journal, 1 of 4. Oh, there's a quest from the journal. How many pages is this? I don't think so. But I'll take it. I don't mind reading a small book, like, 2, maybe 3 pages at max, but that's, No thanks. I can read that on my own time. I ain't got time to read. Where did that actually start, though? Just out of curiosity. I found part of a journal written by someone named Ludwig, who used to live at Clockwork Castle. That reminded me of something about it. Yeah, that sounds reasonable. There's our bed. I wake feeling well rested. What does well rested do? Do you actually get an experience boost in this game? If you know, let me know. I forget. I remember you doing Fallout, but I don't remember if that's a thing in Skyrim. I'm assuming it is, otherwise why would it tell you you're well rested? I've probably asked that before as well. Also, apologies if you can hear airplanes in the background. The window's open. So there may be maybe some aviation going on somewhere behind me. Who's Ludwig? Ludwig, whatever. Well, I would imagine not. What happened?
I believe he kept a series of journals, however. Perhaps the answer can be found in their pages. I recall seeing them scattered around the keep. You might try looking in the master bedroom, mage's study, and travel room.
Okay. Find 2 and 3. Let's do that real quick, actually. I'm not going to read them, but I will find them. So the travel room and the mage's study. Okay. Do it quickly. Shouldn't be too hard to find. It's just a book that looks clearly like a journal. I'm sure it's just laying around somewhere. It doesn't necessarily have to be in here. Expedition supplies. Interesting. Wait, what? Items to be sold. Oh, I think... Oh, shit. If this actually happens... I think later on, once you unlock this, and he says he can do little caravan missions for you, if you put stuff in here and he'll go sell it for you and bring back the gold, that'd be so sick. I hope that's the case. I really do. Well, his journal's clearly not in this room. It's up here somewhere. What's this? Transfer items from receptacle to mage's study. Sort items from inventory to mage's study. Jesus, you can transfer and sort items from here. Very interesting. This is quite different. Okay. Nothing there. No. In here? Come on, Ludwig. Is that it? Yeah. There's 3 or 4. We're not going to read it, of course. Now to the mage's study. Wait, 3 or 4? That means we have... He told me 3 places to look. I already found the one in the master bedroom. That means we'll be missing one. Oh, you do that. Mage's thing was where? This way? Fuck, I forgot. it's upstairs, huh? We'll get some combat soon, boys. Don't you worry. For now, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna do this. There are side quests. I'm gonna do some side quests, you know? There's much to be done. No. This journal probably won't be too difficult to find. Is that a journal? That's not a journal. It doesn't look like a journal. Why would I even think that's a journal? Idiot. No. If he knew where to look for the journals, why didn't he read up on where he went? I guess he's a robot. Doesn't really matter to him, does it? There it is. Between the pages of this journal, you find a key. Tied to it is a label which reads Master Bedroom Wardrobe. Oh. Now that's interesting. Unexpected, but not unwelcome. Alright, let's head to the Master Bedroom Wardrobe. I have no idea what I'm doing from this point on. Like, well, I didn't know what I was doing anyway. But I haven't seen anything up to this point. Like, I knew there was a castle. I knew there was some brothers and sisters. Other than that, I know literally nothing about this mod. So this could be very interesting indeed. I don't get it. Is there a different wardrobe I have to go through? Oh, that looks like it. A false back panel. Jesus. I almost, I guess I can. That's how you make an entrance. Alright. Well, it's a broken pipe. Leaking some water. So we're looking for his journal, huh? Is he back here, like dead or something? He might be. I haven't actually looked around me too much, have I? I could have an enemy to my left, I wouldn't even know it. But I'm fairly convinced he's not back here. There's a lot of books. Oh, there he is. Yeah, we leveled up. Ugh, if only it wasn't so long. He died. Let's put it that way. Okay. We found him at least. Take these. Let's go talk to Robot Boy.
Oh. What are you doing?
Oh.
What are you doing?
I'm exploring. Found a corpse.
That must be Lovig. He used to live here with us. I had not spoken to him for a long time.
Huh. I wonder why.
I suppose he must have died in there.
Yep. How? Why is he still in there?
It was a long time ago for me.
Makes sense, I guess. You forgot.
I am nearly 4,000 years old.
Oof.
For me, time is difficult.
That's pretty old, not gonna lie.
Men and women are victims of time, whereas I turn for a moment to ponder, and when I turn back, you're all dead.
Shit. Ludwig?
Towards the end, Ludwig shut himself away and would see no one. Items such as food and books were sent up using the pneumatic tube system. For a time, Lahar continued to deliver his food, and the food was eaten. I believe now that the vermin began to eat the food once Ludwig stopped.
But now his body is still in there.
Taking his Lahar's sole interest.
That's fair.
You're still here.
Yep, can you please move? God. Creepy bitch. Get out of my way. She doesn't even have a female face. It's freaking me out. Lahar? Where are you? Buddy? Wait, what? Oh, I gotta get the mausoleum key from her. Okay, we'll do that too.
You're still here.
Yep, steam pipeline is broken.
I see.
So the travel machine isn't working.
Yes. Then you can stay.
Oh, thank you. Stay here in the castle?
Simple. You are trapped here, therefore you cannot leave here, therefore you must live here.
Hmm, yeah? I hear you said you asked you for the key to the mausoleum.
Yes. Give me the key. Lahar can be simple. If he had decided to go back down there and try to fix the pipeline again, he might not have returned.
That is likely. Could I have the key?
You wish to try to fix the pipeline yourself. Very well. Here.
Thanks. I have questions. Are you one of the Dwemer?
Somewhat.
I'm actually kind of interested. Can you tell me something of the Dwemer, then?
Very well. Abak-Jumar Kik-Jumay Thums Amakai. The Abak-Chavadol Kik-Ortium Kik-Thimsen.
Is that legit Dwemer? I don't understand.
No, you wouldn't.
Thanks. A strange ghost is following me in the tunnels.
Ghosts are not particularly unusual. They are a recognized phenomenon.
Yes, but there's something unusual about this one.
How so?
Just being near it hurt terribly. Did it, though? Terribly? It's not the word I would use. Made a strange wailing sound. It followed me for a long while, but it did little else.
I see.
Just being near it hurt terribly.
I see.
It made a strange wailing sound.
A sound. I see.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Very well.
You robotic bastard. Your voice is quite unusual.
No mouth, no lips, no tongue, and no throat. My heart shivers in my chest, and words are produced from my speaker horn.
Sure.
Very well.
That sounds like a thing. Okay. Just about done. Let's go talk to... we can talk to him when we get back. Fuck it. Let's go underground. I need to kill something. And I think her brothers and sisters sound like the perfect targets. Alright, so where the hell do I go? This way? Indeed. The mausoleum. Alright, let's save it up. Alright. Down we go into the depths. We got a bit of time left, okay. What's this? Shrine to Arcay. Don't mind if I do. Are those hawk feathers? Yeah, I'll take that. I'll be having that. I like how long and petty I will just be about taking one gold piece off the ground. It's like, it's just there. I have to take it. It's more tempting to take it off the ground like that than it is to off a body. I don't know why. Because it literally doesn't make any sense. Maybe it's just because it's really visible. I don't know. Who knows? Wait, was that a... I didn't even see how much it was. No. Not a skill book. Okay. So I guess we follow the pipeline. We're collecting leather strips as we go. What do we have here? Does this heal? Okay. That'll do. I'll keep heal ready. I don't think we need our sword drawn yet, though. Until we find enemies, which I'm sure will be very, very shortly. As soon as we go down there, we'll find feral robots or something. Shumshing? Yep. That's how I talk now. Knapsack. What the fuck is that? I'll take these, though. Little metal ingots. Okay. The Dwemer were quite amazing, weren't they? I mean, look at that lamp! That's... Is that not impressive? Are you not impressed? Technological marvels. The Hall of Elements. Okay. I'm ready. I do hope I don't run into any crashes or anything, because that would be really bad. I don't know how particularly stable the mod is. I mean, it's a newer mod as of recording this video, so who knows? There could be problems. So far, so good, though. Seems pretty smooth. I haven't had a single hiccup or issue, as far as I can tell. Except for when I actually reloaded my save file after the last video, after that wailing was going on. I loaded up the save file and the wailing stopped, so I actually loaded an earlier save and got back to that point. So the wailing was there when I started the video again. But, actually, on the way back I got a new spell I forgot about. Blessed Weapon. Summons an axe imbued with divine energy to fight for you for 60 seconds. Let's check it out. There'll probably be conjuration, I would imagine. No? Yes. Okay, let's try it. Cool. Well, it was cool until it immediately disappeared. Oh, no, it's still there. Oh, hello.
Sometimes.
Sometimes I get to thinking.
You know me. Why don't you come with me?
What?
No. I won't bite.
I won't bite your face. Come away with me.
Oh boy. Ah! Fuck! Jesus, the creepy! Alright. I won't bite your face. I'm not convinced. Not convinced, robot thing. Oops. I meant to pull out my shield. The paladin shield. Oh, dead? Yeah. That one's dead. Not particularly strong, are they? Ooh! Ah, there was a potential couple good ones there. I wish you didn't make this that camera sound when I use that. I wonder if you can turn that off. You probably can, I'd imagine. I'll take this as well. They have dwarven shields. I'm sure they're full of dwarven stuff, actually. I'm actually not going to take the dwarven stuff. I'm going to try and stay light, if I can. And only take light things. I'll probably end up not adhering to that very well. So we'll see. What does that do? Is that what lowers the lever? Are the things? Perhaps. Oh yeah, we need to level up. Alright. Let's see what we can do. I think we're going to start pouring some points into Magicka again. What can I go with Restoration now? We are 44, don't have 50 yet, unfortunately. I would love Recovery too, but that's 50. Wards are 2 times stronger. God, I'm having trouble with words today. Stronger and faster than ever before. Let's see about this. Smithing is 95. Yeah, smithing is 95. I can make Dwarven autocannon. I think that's the one thing I'm not going to do and counterfeit. I don't see any reason to do this. 50% chance to retain any materials you spend in advanced grindstone or workbench. When activating a grindstone or advanced workbench, you may choose to sacrifice a dragon soul to improve the items further one tier during that session. That could be good. I could increase my stuff even better. What's iron lore? If you specialize in arm type, your attacks ignore 15% of the armor rating of enemies wearing items of chosen type. If you specialize in weapon type, you take 10% less damage from weapons of the chosen type. So, iron lore makes it so my attacks ignore 15% of heavy armor. That's pretty nice, actually. Pretty nice indeed, if I do say so myself. Iron lore for the win. Alright. Let's go this way first. What's behind me? That's definitely the way to go, so we'll look and see what's in here. There's a big Dwemer head. There's a chest with expert lock. Of course there is. Someone joked that my Halloween special, I should do a thing with just tons of master locks. I thought that was funny. That sounds terrifying. More terrifying than any scary game could ever be. And I think not. Alright, hello? Anybody home? No? Good. There's nothing particularly of use in here. Just a lot of potions laying around, which I'm alright with. I really do need to go through my potions, I think. I'm probably carrying a bunch of potions I don't need to be carrying. Taking up extra weight. For something maybe I'll never have, like increased two-handed attack power or something like that. I don't use two-handers. Oh boy. That's cool. That, actually, should be our thumbnail. Maybe like this? Or maybe like this? Yeah. Now we're talking. I'm such a whore for screenshots. I do apologize. But, well, I can't help it. I love a beautiful screenshot. Alright. I'll keep that on so I know where I'm going. This looks very interesting. This reminds me of Blackreach. The vanilla dungeon. Except this is definitely different. Whoa. This place is massive. The hell? Oh. Hello. Fuck off. I think they can count as wearing heavy armor as well, which is good. Yeah, get wrecked. I love the fact I'm getting 10 gold per kill thing. Let's heal up our stamina. God, that's nice. I'll leave the rest of the junk. I guess I don't really need a shield particularly right now. Just swing and heal, swing and heal. Although I do like using shields, so. Eh. That looks like a breached pipe if I've ever seen one. But it very well may not be. Oh, you. You are weak. Scrubs. Okay. I'm not sure which way to go first, to be honest. It's definitely got options. Just making sure there's nothing in the water. Looks, oh, let's not go that way. That looks like a waterfall. Is my light on? Oh, it is on. Just doesn't work in the water, of course. I knew that. Problem with having a healing spell on my in my hand is it does kind of block my vision a little bit. Obscures my vision so much that I'm just like, ah, I can't focus on the actual background where I'm going. I'll pull out a healing spell when I need it. Let's be honest, shields are cool. I love a good sword and board. Actually, what was that spell called? That lightning spell we got in the tunnel. That was pretty good. I have no fucking idea what it's called, though. It wasn't Crackle. It was some sort of lightning spell. I guess I could find it in my magics thing. That'd probably be pretty good against these dudes. Is that Electrify? Your weapon does lightning damage. No, that's not it. Applies electrical charge. It was this one, wasn't it? Is it working? Eh, doesn't really feel like it is. But you. It's literally doing nothing. Oh. Press V to trigger it. Which is kind of inconvenient. Considering I'm using a controller. So I have to press on my keyboard. That's pretty good though. But that's not the one, was it? The one I was using was actually killing them. Without me having to do anything. Lightning bolt, lightning runes, sparks. It's not that. I guess that was it. 52 crackle's actually pretty good. Alright, gilded shell. Time to get fried. It's got an interesting sound to it. Is 52 actually not that good? Fascinating. Now die! It's very, very bad, actually. Never mind. Fuck magic. Come here, you scum. Okay, cross. Oh. That was odd. Crossbow it is. You forced my hand. I missed. Where'd you go? Come back here. There we go, headshot. The finest in Dwemer technology. I guess they would be the finest in Dwemer technology, actually. They're kind of the most advanced thing I've seen in Dwemer. Fully humanoid robots. With AI and such. Not just mindless centurions. I guess we go down that way. Which, I guess I could take the shortcut. Hopefully it's a deep pool. It's always a little dangerous jumping into a pool of water, you're not sure how far down it goes. Oh wow, that does some damage. I like them apples. Why isn't it working? I'm trying to Fusper Da and it's not doing anything. Oh no. Fail. I think my Fusper Da was lagging. Which is odd. Alright, enough of this. Enough of this game! You're dead. Nothing on him. I have a feeling we're gonna be down here a while, guys. Or girls, if you're a girl. Odds are slim, but hey, you never know. I highly doubt I have very many female watchers? Viewers? I guess that would be the word I'm looking for. Of Skyrim, but you never know. Maybe my fantastic voice is drawing them all here. Something tells me not so much. Alright, let me, oh, fuck. Come on. Will you just open? There we go. Expert. As always, magic over generous 25% faster. That actually is pretty nice to have. That means I have a ring and an amulet if I want to get rid of the 70 health amulet. Which is a good amount of health, but at the same time, I don't really need it, do I? Nice. I was very tempted to take a screenshot. Could you feel it? Could you feel the tension of me just itching to press the button? The F12 key. Which is screenshot, of course, on Steam, in case you're unaware of that. F12 is how you take screenshots on Steam. Boy. This place is a labyrinth of staircases, is it not? I guess I just have to keep going downwards. That seems reasonable. There's so much I haven't been to, like over there, and... Oh boy. There's a lot of there and shit. This place has a lot of different looks to it. Like, that is looks very cool. That looks really cool. Like, oh, man. So far, I'm very impressed by this, actually. That looks like a bursted pipe. I've ever seen one. I haven't actually ran into a pipe to repair a pipe with, though. So I'm not sure what that's about. I'm sure I'll know what I'm looking for when I get there. Yeah? Well, maybe you should stop thinking. That's my thought on that. Now give me that gold. That's sweet, sweet gold. Alright, these aren't pipes or anything I can take, right? Of course I can't take. This is fucking massive. I saw some movement. He's running off that way, though. Good riddance. But not really, because I actually need to kill you. Come back! Alright. You know what time it is. Oh. Goodbye. I think it's still alive. It's quick. Ooh, shit. Almost like power attacked my way off there. Bitch. All right. Screw that guy. I'm guessing the problems are at the bottom somewhere. And they'll be small, obviously. Berethor's not going to be able to repair this, I mean. Let's be reasonable. Okay, this looks familiar. I came from this way. Looks like I do have to keep a little bit of track of where I'm going and where I've been. Otherwise, I will get lost. So I have a look at the map just for shits and giggles. Oh, God. It's like a Daggerfall map. Layers upon layers over each other. That looks really cool. I don't know, that might make a cooler screenshot. Maybe. Maybe. Like so. Like I say, you never know which one you're going to use. So might as well take multiples. Alright. I'll probably just use that as my desktop background, to be honest. I do it all the fucking time. Mortal Lair. I feel like I missed a bunch. All the ways lead down, but... Do they lead down differently? Also, do I have a quest I'm tracking? Repair the steam rupture 0 of 10. Oh boy. Well, it can't be here. You guys creep me out! Like, I'm finding these robots a little bit more creepy than the actual ghost. Which probably was not the intended effect, I would imagine. The ghost would have been creepy, like I said, if he was actually hurt. Like, if it was scary. You have the fear of death. Since you feel so overpowered in Skyrim, it's hard to be scared. But yes. Oh, shit. Don't die, don't die. I will not perish. Not this day. So I do wish they would have made the ghost a little bit stronger. Imagine if she just came near you, you just started dying rapidly. You'd be very scared. You'd be like, oh god, I need to get away from this ghost. It's terrifying. Keep you up here. Pentagram or scrap metal? Do I don't need that. Anybody else want a piece? I got one of those indoor suns. Just like the Forgotten City head. Yep, I'm not convinced still. Shit. How dare you, Ward? What? Oh, that's okay. One shot her anyway. Goodbye. Diamonds are forever. What? It's cool to have a different enemy type, though. Like, they're not just Centurions and stuff. He made his own, like, mobs, essentially. Which is pretty cool. I like that. And they're properly nice looking, you know? They fit the aesthetic. They are very well done. They have cool voices. Disassembled Dwemer pipe. Ah, shit. They are around here. Oh, boy. I haven't been looking out as much as I should have been. Poor said Dwemer pipes. This is the beginning, isn't it? But I clearly haven't been this way. Because there's mobs over here. So we may be wandering these halls looking for ruptured pipes. There's one. I guess they're not hard to spot. They say random shit, which is weird. Alright, come on, scum! Let's go third-person combat. Yeah. I do like a little bit of third-person combat every now and then. Oh, Jesus. Oh, jeez. I like how Confused Rodal while facing the other way. It's impressive. Yeah. Oh, that would have been a great screenshot. I failed. Come on, bitch. Berethor, screenshot master! Oh, yeah. God, come on! Let's heal up some stamina so I can do some more power attacks. Should probably stop doing the... I keep doing the backwards power attack, which, as you might expect, is easy to miss with. It's moving backwards to do it. I feel like that person dropped before I even got to him. Woo! That was fun. Storm Strike. Charges the target, causing 9 shock damage per second. Oh, that was the thing we had. That was the spell I was looking for earlier. But because I loaded an earlier save, I didn't get Stormstrike in that box. I got the other one. Oh, that's good. We got Stormstrike back. Because I knew the other one wasn't the right one. I was like, you didn't have to detonate it. Stormstrike, though, would be actually useful here. Where's Destruction? Alright, let's put it on our hotbar. Let's actually equip it as well. We'll use it. Yeah. Talk about. We'll get our Emperor Palpatine on. It'll be good. Alright, let's take that Dwemer oil. Nope. Just a bunch of Dwemer garbage. Lockpicks and stamina poison? Sure. Okay. So now that I know I'm actually looking for those pipes, just gotta keep an eye out. Go to where they are, and there should be a disassembled pipe next to it, I guess. I just gotta put it back on. I hope it's that easy. Wasn't it here? Oh, piss. You actually need disassembled Dwemer pipes, and there's not anything next to it. Oh boy. Apparently I can make my own down here somewhere. So I gotta find a bunch of disassembled Dwemer pipes and then carry them over here. That sounds fun. Alright, well, in that case, look how far down this goes. Should we check out the mortal lair? Why not? Oh god, it's already been an hour. Son of a bitch. I feel like I'm just getting into it. I'm going to be recording 2 sessions of this in a row, though, so I'll definitely get my fill, but... Holy shit. Well, this place is enormous! I wonder how long this mod took to make. Because holy shit. I'm impressed by the sheer scale of this dungeon alone. Not to mention the house mod. Not to mention the quest thing before it with the cave. No wonder it's a 5 to 7 hour playthrough. And for me, it'll probably be longer because I'll be lost in these damn Dwemer ruins. Yeah, no. No, I can't. That's definitely not as good at these, is it? Just wrecking skeletons, but skeletons are garbage, so I guess that's not surprising. This person's actually pretty strong. Alright, you're dead. I'll take your arrows and your lockpicks. So that's a shitty spell, no point in using it. I'll just keep healing. Yeah, I'm gonna call it here, I think, after I kill whatever this is. Come here, fly away.
Fly away with me.
Fly, you fools! Ah, they're smart. Oh, Jesus. Hello. Oh, boy. Not like this! I hate being cornered. Ah! The mage. The mage needs to die. I missed. Come on. Please. Well, I hit one of them. There we go. What if you can decapitate these robots? Probably not. I'm on fire! Ah! After fighting some combat like this, I don't think I'd want to take off the Nicholas of Peerless health, to be honest. It's quite useful to have 70 extra health. That's a good amount. That is no little amount. Damn, man. These robots are everywhere. Another mage. Another mage to die! For justice! Oh shit. Oh shit. Will not perish, not like this. You. Whoa, yeah. Very cool. Ow. Alright, scumbag. You're going down. Oh, sick. The other guy ruined it. Or maybe he didn't. God, I didn't expect a fucking army of these things. I just wanted to end my video, man. Come on now. Well, at least next video, I won't have any combat left. I say it like it's a good thing. I'm sure there's plenty more robots. Oh. Well, the good news is I can do the looting off camera. And then, just carry on from there, I guess. I say that. I'll take that. Alright, very cool. Clockwork's getting interesting. We gotta repair some stuff. I am absolutely covered in blood, even though they bleed oil. Unless that's my own blood, I guess, maybe. I think it. I need to see a doctor. But, we'll see a doctor next time. So, hopefully you guys enjoyed that, and we'll continue going through the Clockwork quest line. For some time, I guess. Probably like 4 or 5 videos, I'd imagine. Something like that, maybe. I don't mind. But, yeah. Should be good, and I will see you all in part 25. See you guys next time.